Yeah, I watched the. It's not a movie. It's a documentary. It's called "The Show Must Go On," and it's a story about Queen. What happened after Freddie Mercury died, and it focuses immediately a lot on the singer that they use now, the singer from America, Adam Lambert. I was curious. I had some time over. I was already, I think, to bed, and I thought, let's watch something cool and new. And there wasn't that much new on Netflix in Romania, at least the last couple of weeks. And I saw this. I was like, cool. And I never knew anything about the singer that they use now, Adam Lambert. So I thought, okay, interesting, because he's a very, very out there person. He's even more than Freddie Mercury, of course. Being a gay man is more accepted now, so it's easier maybe for this man to be, to dress all the way he wants. And I think it's also a bit like, I think Freddie Mercury would be proud to see someone like this, you know?
Yeah.
So it was interesting, and because I saw also the movie that we all saw, Bohemian Rhapsody, which I liked, but I still thought there's a lot more to tell. So I was curious, and if I would summarize it, it's left me a little bit disappointed in the sense that, again, I feel like there's a lot to tell, but they don't. It's also controlled again by the members of Queen, which are mainly now the drummer and the guitar player, because the bass player is still in charge of financial stuff, but he's really on the background since he never played the gig anymore after, I think, Live. It was the last one even, I think.
Okay, yeah.
So it was interesting to see. They show you the first shots where they use a lot of real footage. Also, what happens? How they really boost up Freddie Mercury as a singer, which is, in my opinion, not overdone. It's very respectful because he was that ridiculously good. He had that ridiculous range. Also, because of the teeth, of course, he had a special range, and they really describe. Also, what we saw in the movie, they describe how difficult it is for them also to find a singer that can even match with them, because you need a singer that can play disco, that can play rock opera, that can play hard rock, that can play disco, funk, everything. That's why not only Freddie Mercury, why Queen was that good, but for musicians, it's easier to switch. If you're really good trained, you can do a lot. Doesn't mean you're good at everything, but you're okay enough. And for a singer, it's very hard. So that was nice. I didn't really think of that, because I was never a big fan of Queen. I liked
me neither. After Bohemian Rhapsody, the movie, I got more. I liked the songs already, but after Bohemian, I never knew his story. So that makes you connect a bit more to it.
No, I checked it more. I'm always a big fan of the Foo Fighters, and the drummer of the Foo Fighters is even called Taylor, and Taylor is the last name of the drummer, Roger Taylor. He was named after him. So I always, because of them, being a fan of them, I always checked the Queen out a bit, but I liked the songs. I liked always the guitar work and the drums, and I always knew Freddie Mercury had a ridiculously good voice, but also till the movie, I wasn't a big fan, and now I'm more of a fan, and I checked some CDs also out. And so this documentary is showing you nicely a bit, takes you into the mind of them. Like, okay, guys, we know we had this amazing singer that, they knew we cannot find someone like him, and what to do. And they all were okay with not doing anything. And then after a while, they were asked to do a musical in London, and Brian May, the guitar player, was really heavily involved, and then also the drummer became involved, and they also started playing with them live in the musical with some episodes, some nights, and they realized, we have to do something with this music, you know, we cannot just let this be. And they found first, of course, the first era they did live was with I think Paul Rodgers was his name.
And
that was a bit, in my opinion, not so respectful, because they, he's a huge singer, and they had a very good run with him for, I think, 2 or 3 years. And they show you they have respect for him, but they put his story like, okay, this is done.
Yeah.
You know, so that was a bit like, that was your first singer. And now the whole show presents the documentary like, we found Adam Lambert.
Yeah,
I was like,
true.
Okay, but you first found this guy.
He's made, because I remember now that you tell, I've seen this documentary. I'm not sure, because I was Googling, and I think it came out already in 2019, but it's now on Netflix, so I guess I've seen it just on
TV. Possible. I thought it was new. Okay, it's possible.
So I've seen it on TV, I think, but what I remember is they make him very, very big. Yeah. Yeah.
And in a way, I understand that because he's their guy now, and he vocally he's very good.
Yeah.
He's impressive, but yeah,
it's different.
It's different, and I like the way the looks, everything is so over top, which is, it fits really good with the band.
Yeah,
and it can be cool. You can like it, and that's your own opinion. But what I think is that, yeah, vocally wise, even if it's technically really good, I'm not impressed with his voice.
I think like where, and I'm you're the musician. I'm not a musician, yeah. So maybe I shouldn't even talk about it.
I feel like
Freddie Mercury had a bit more rawness, not really in his voice, but to his timbre or something. It was more raw. Where Lambert is very polished. He's almost like a musical star in his.
But that's the problem. That's how he started. He became in this business after doing The Voice, I think, American Idol.
Yeah, before which is, that. By the way, fun. I don't know if you've seen these clips. It's fun. Yeah.
No, and the funny thing is that he is a musical actor before he even goes there.
Yeah, yeah.
And Simon Cowell also you see in this documentary. And so the thing for me is like, okay, technically, but that's the thing with most musical good singers. Technically, they're very advanced, and it's very impressive. So this man can sing like crazy good, but the rawness of a real rock musician is something you cannot learn.
Exactly.
You know?
Yeah.
And that's the same thing. Like also Robbie Williams was that famous not because he was a boy band guy.
Nay.
He also had that rawness.
That guy. His character that you hear in the voice.
Yeah. He had that same with like a guy like Bruce Springsteen. Brian
That's why
Adams.
Gary Barlow didn't work. Everybody thought Gary Barlow was going to make it.
He was too slick, too beautiful, the voice was too polished. Exactly. Yeah.
Yeah.
No, so that's the thing. Like, it was interesting to see. I didn't like that they put only the focus on this man because, in my opinion, he's just very lucky to reach this, and he deserves it. Maybe that's not the problem, he didn't add something special to the band, in my opinion. Right. So it's cool that they play with a man that doesn't sound like Freddie, which is perfect, which you don't want to have, because otherwise you can just hire a guy that can do like an impression of him.
Yeah, true.
But I missed again the same with the movie. I missed a bit of depth. But
what I do remember, and correct me if I'm wrong, but what I do remember from this documentary is that they did went a bit into his insecurities and the things he was coping with the Lambert guy.
Yeah, well, that was interesting to see. To see his background, of course. That was interesting, but I don't think I was interested in him enough. I have more respect now for him, which is nice, because I simply didn't know him. Nah. I always thought, okay, he's a good singer, but it didn't reach me, the voice. And now you have more respect for him. It's just a guy that worked really hard to get to a certain level and then was super lucky enough to get picked up by like huge rock legends.
Yeah.
It's a very nice American story, of course. It was nice to watch. It was enjoyable.
Yeah. So if you would have to rate it, 5 stars?
3.5 maybe even.
3.5. Yeah. That's quite okay. Thank you again for watching. Talk and discuss with us in the comments. We mostly react to everything. So like the video if you liked it, of course. And if you're not subscribed yet, then don't forget to hit that subscribe button and help us grow the channel. That was it. Koen, hasta la vista.
Hasta la vista.
See you next
week. Ciao, man.